So this is going to be a glaucoma case. Now the glaucoma ERG is different. It's different than the 30 hertz implicit time. It's a little bit more challenging to do because it's an amplitude-based test. And so, I'll show you how it's a little bit different compared to the 30 hertz implicit time, but this is a case where the ERG can help you. All right. So this is a 66-year-old male, history of cataract surgery in the left eye. Unfortunately, this patient was lost to follow-up and came in after several years presenting for blurred vision in both eyes. Patient had a history of multiple back surgeries and had a significant cataract in the right eye. Okay, patient had cupping on exam, about 0.7 in each eye, but did look like there was a notch superiorly in the left eye. So what do you do with these typical, these cases? Standard of care, visual field test first, okay? So we get the visual field test, right eye looks like, a lid artifact, left eye, inferior defect, and probably correlates to the notch in the nerve, superior part of the nerve. Okay, next thing, old way again, OCT. So I get a nerve fiber layer and you see cupping in both eyes, okay? The nerve fiber layer, it's certainly abnormal in the left eye, but it's abnormal in both eyes. And maybe it's a little bit worse in the left eye, but they look about the same. So here's the dilemma in this situation. So the patient's sitting there in your chair, you have to decide what to do. There's optic nerve damage to the left eye. Patient has a significant cataract surgery in the right eye. But the view to the nerve on the right eye is confounded due to the dense lens. And so the field doesn't help you. And the OCT looks about the same. So what do we do? So the old way, again, we have to make a decision at this point. But the new way, what I do is I come out, ask for, this time, glaucoma ERG, testing tick does it, imports it, and we review it. So this is what a glaucoma ERG looks like. This is not the patients. I'll show you the patients in a second. I kind of wanted to show you roughly what a normal looks like. Again, a ton of information in there. Don't let that kind of scare you away. I will show you where you have to look, okay? So where we want to look is, this is the photopic negative response. It is the response of the ganglion cell layer, okay? And it is the measurement that we use for glaucoma is an amplitude-based measurement, okay? And so that means that the reason I said it's harder to pull off, the electrode position matters much more when you're trying to get an amplitude position. So in the beginning, researchers, really smart researchers, when they were looking at this, they were using amplitude of the photopic negative response alone to determine if there's glaucoma or if there's a problem at the ganglion cell layer. Well, it turns out you can't do that because, again, it's an amplitude-based test. If the overall test is diminished for whatever reason, say dense cataracts or if the electrode position's a little bit off, well, the photopic negative response is gonna be off because the overall electrical activity is off. So then these smart researchers, scientists decided, well, why don't we make a ratio? So that's what we use. And there's two different ratios right now, and we use both of them. And so we look at the P ratio and the W ratio, okay? Basically, these are two different ways to look at the relative response of the ganglion cell to the overall retinal function, or really the bipolar function. But so does that make sense? So that's what's neat and really key about this. So we look at the P ratio. Okay, so this was a standard. Let's look at my patient with glaucoma in the left eye. What kind of glaucoma does he have in his right eye? What do we offer surgical-wise? So again, a lot to look at. We're gonna focus in here. So in this case, the photopic negative response, P ratio, W ratio, significantly depressed. And so it's green, but again, I don't care necessarily about that it's green because I wanna compare it to the other eye. And the other eye, it's much more normal? Okay, because I know the patient has glaucoma damage to the left eye, but I want to know how much damage in their right eye. Much better result in the right eye. Okay, so the left one, great example of early glaucoma atrophy damage with visual field loss. In the right eye, much better. So because the glaucoma ERG of the right eye is significantly better than the left eye, it's a reassuring result. So when I see this, this gives me confidence in proceeding with premium cataract surgery in this case. Now, again, I tend to be a more conservative premium cataract surgeon. So because of the potential glaucoma down the road, I'd probably avoid a multifocal. You can decide for yourself what you want to do, especially after you have that discussion with the patient. I guess it depends on how old the patient is. But you could certainly consider an extended depth of focus or toric lens or femto.